This week in Onuha Uncensored.
Yo, Samuel, what are we doing?
Maybe switching in the SVR.
What do you think of this one? Ruben messaged me. Your Insta is banned.
We have a strategy session, a business session.
That's what you need to pay to park in Amsterdam if you don't have a parking spot, man. What a scumbags, but of course, that's why we make money and we'll pay it.
So guys, just did some grocery. Now I'm going to a good friend of mine, chilling on a boat, good boat day. The weather is nice, it's like 25 degrees. So of course it's nice in the Netherlands. It's not that many days of the year warm weather. So the days that it is warm weather, of course you need to enjoy it. Still on the 75 hard, so no drinks for me, but that's no problem. I will catch some sun, drink some sparkling and eat some fruits. But no, I love it. That's finally good weather again, because summer almost over in Amsterdam, so good to enjoy it. So I'm driving now, I'll see you later.
I've been on the road, I'm gone. Private jet for me and I'm Rosie. Extra Renzo, pick up clothes. I made a fence and hit my hose up. Down the road, I'm on one. It ain't bad right now, it's the long run. I've been acting way too humble.
So normally you're chilling there at the other side, Brad?
Yes, of course. But it's for the people that they don't have a boat or something.
Yeah. So Brad, since you have a boat, everyone wants to be your friend, right?
Yeah. Look like him now.
Yeah, now he's on the boat. Normally he never talks to them, but since you have the boat, everybody wants to chill. But only the dogs can chill, man.
Mm-hmm. Ivy.
Purash.
Purash.
Ja, niet te puur. Niet te puur. Half om half.
En Wiet wel?
Ja, Wiet wel.
Ja, Wiet ook. Oké.
Nou, Brett, je hoort het.
Ja, je hebt... Ze willen twee joints van ons hebben.
That's how it goes in Amsterdam. The kids. 10 years old already doing drugs.
There's no weed every day.
Yeah, the Netherlands is fucked up. After a long boat day, we need some good food, some protein. Miles also needs some good protein, he needs to grow big. Good morning guys, it's Sunday, 9 a.m. What are we going to do, Samuel?
Sunday morning, while everyone is sleeping, everyone has a fucking hangover from yesterday, drinking too much. We are on the grind. We have a strategy session, a business session scheduled. I invested in a business mentor who is gonna build out the back end of our entire company. So we have a full day plan. It's gonna be very crazy, because at the level we are at right now and scaling rapidly, it's very good to have a complete overview of what's happening. And also, we want to remove ourselves from the day-to-day operations, of course, and meanwhile still growing. That's a process. That's not something that will happen by itself. We are here to crush competition, to annihilate everyone.
Who not how? So last month we are very busy with hiring new people. That's like one of my main tasks. So why would you do that yourself if you also could get help with it? Learn from somebody that has already done it and build out structures for other companies. So that's what we are going to do. Next to that, I'm also had a call last week with a recruitment person, so that can also help us with hiring new people. Yeah, we're only leveling up, as you might know.
Bro, leveling up, working around the clock. And you know what the difference is with us? We could be chilling right now. We did, what was it, 1.5, 1.6 last month. Bro, we can be chilling, laying on the beach, doing nothing. But what are we doing? I invested 15,000 in a mentor who's coming today to train us personally and build the back end from our fucking company. Who does that? Most people don't.
Sunday
do it.
Morning.
Sunday morning.
Yeah, well, yesterday we did a little 70k.
Did a little 70k. We are leveling up each and every day. But the main reason how we are able to do that is we keep investing. Meanwhile, we are winning. And that's what most of our competition is not doing. We have all the inside information, we have the best network, and we fucking know our competition is sleeping like a motherfucker. So what are we then gonna do? No, we are not just gonna work a little here and there and win from them. No, we're gonna completely destroy them. We are gonna take over their own fucking markets. Because that's what we do. We are competitive, and I like that. We grew past fucking brands that I used to look up to when I started Icon. Right now, winning.
Exactly, and when discipline meets like hard work, that's what we call luck. luck doesn't exist, but when you live so disciplined and put all the hard work in it, all opportunities come on you, you know.
When preparation meets opportunity, that's fucking luck. And that's why I hate when people say you got lucky, because the chances you have, that I have and everyone else have, they're all the fucking same. They're all the same, but we see them. Most people, they're sleeping. They're still getting the dust out of their eyes from last night partying too hard. Meanwhile, we are spotting all the advantages, everything where we can improve. That's it. Never tell yourself that others got lucky or that they found something you didn't found. They found it for a reason while you was fucking sleeping.
You don't deserve shit, and that's why God doesn't give you shit.
It's fact.
We're going to build 100% self-steering, self-regulating, and self-leading teams in this amazingly great icon environment. Just one small thing, the real warriors are gathering here because it's Sunday morning, early as fuck, and already in the game.
We're building an empire. So
what I implement are the most effective and most easy Silicon Valley growth strategies and tactics. How Elon Musk, how Jeff Bezos, how Google manages their companies from day one. And what do I mean with day one? Because it's really simple to implement, but it's very effective and it's very hard to discover. But if you do it right, well, that's what they say in Silicon Valley, you'll reach hyper growth by maximizing the input and output of the whole company. You just go sky high.
What are we doing? What are we doing?
We are leveling up the complete business, man. You will see in the next 3 to 4 months.
Boom!
Game changer.
When you talk with this guy, you think, what did I do in the last 5 years?
How did I make it so far?
How are we doing millions a month?
We're stupid.
Guys, someone in the comments, please tell me, why are Moroccan guys scared of dogs? Every time something gets delivered and I walk to the door and it's a Moroccan delivery driver, they're scared as shit of this little fucking dog that doesn't even know how to bark, let alone bite someone. I don't know, man. I don't know. Did your father or your mother tell you to run from fucking dogs or something? Or have you been bitten by a police dog after a football match or something? Fucking hell, man.
Guys, when people used to talk shit, you just show them the Shopify revenue dashboard. But right now I found a new flex.
Total inventory cost. Here, we have for a fucking million in purchasing price, just chilling there at the fucking warehouse. More goods coming in.
Bro, next time you hate, show me what the fuck you have laying there in inventory. But on a side note, not to forget, we did do
70,000 yesterday.
Yes, people, they don't want to see us win. I wake up, Ruben messaged me. He said, your Insta is banned. So I already had these crazy login issues and now they completely banned my account. Fucking bullshit, man. They don't want to see us win. But let's see, 6:30 in the morning. Guys, if I have issues, I'm on it. Look, guys, just look how many messages I already have. 6, 6, 6, 6, boom, boom, boom. Guys, I'm proactive as fuck. When I have problems, I solve them. Speed is king. So already like 15 messages, 6:30 in the morning. You guys, when you have a problem, you're not urgent enough. You're not urgent. I wake up and I'm like this gotta get fixed now.
Yo, Samuel, what are we doing?
Yeah, so we're checking out maybe switching in the SVR. Want something more maybe for the summer, two SUVs. It's gangster, obviously. But maybe this we swap in for something low. So maybe let's check inside.
But we are going to miss the SVR, man. I think one of the best SUVs there is, with no doubt. What do you think?
Is something like this saying that?
Yeah, man,
we need something, I think, more for the haters, Ruben. What do you think?
I love this one. But we also have another one, a F1 safety car. Mad Aston Martin. Let me guys what you think of this one.
Does it fit me? Does it suit me?
Very criminal. Or go for a real race car, for the GP Elite. Yes guys, here at CA Gallery. What do you think of this one? McLaren. Sky, what are you saying? What are you saying? Guys, how good is it if you have a dog that you can bring everywhere? Sky.
Hey. Guys.
You guys have a dog that barks and annoys every motherfucker. You cannot bring it nowhere because you look like a dumbhead that's ashamed of himself. My dog is a flex.
Yes, people. So, right now, it's 9:47. We just came from the car dealership. I showed you this morning, my fucking IG got banned completely off the radar. I messaged like 20 people in my network, all my connections, Facebook reps, Facebook insiders. I messaged every fucking one under the sun because I want my shit back, you know? It's now 9:47. Apparently, my account is back online. When I'm back at the office, I'll try to log in. But guys, that's how it works. If you have speed, if you have urgency, that's how you get things done. Most of you guys, you sleep on your fucking problems. You have problems, you, oh, I'll check in a few hours. Nah, bro, I was up 5 a.m. messaging every fucking one I know. And that's how you solve problems. Urgent, push, stay on top of things. Doesn't matter what it is, and it will get solved. Same with your success. If you are hungry and you keep pushing, you will achieve it.
Guys, how do your neighbors and your brother pull up? And you go to office in an Urus SVR and a little Bentley. That's the difference. So which ones are you working on at the moment?
So these ones here, this is the stretch, slim fit stretch shirt. This is sent out yesterday. This is the new cargo pants based off the column block. And then we have what Ruben tried on last week, the jogging set. And then we just got in the iconic tracksuits,
yeah,
which we've sent to China.
I'm excited to see how they will match with the bottoms, you know?
Yeah, I know, exactly, 100%. I think it's going to be...
We already received them, but the size was not good. And the logo was at the front, so we'll do it at the back.
Yeah, and we'll do this...
Where do you have the fleece ones? Ruben showed me this morning. Yeah. Those, oh, so yeah.
These ones are, in terms of from my experience, for our age group, like, guys, the simple, we were talking about that, especially the technical jackets, you know, the older guys like to wear that. This is from Loro Piama, of course, you know, more high-end, but...
I like these, personally.
Yeah, no, 100%. Matches. Yeah. So, like, these are perfect as well for, which we have this, a thing like this, but I think you would have to try out first this variation.
Yeah, that
right?
One...
I mean, you guys are both
this
wearing...
This one is the main focus, because I know that our audience wants...
And then Koma, you guys have enough gems now, but
maybe for the winter, or some new ones.
Darker shades, variations.
I think we already have.
You have a
because
lot
we
here.
Just launched the Callum jeans, and we already have like 6-7 colors
so
of the Lorenzo jeans.
Good work, Angelo.
My top, man.
Yes, guys. Here at the office, everyone is working. Got my juice, so really busy. There's things going on. So yeah, let's get it today.
End of the day at the office, another killer day. Now I'm gonna head home, have some food, and then Elite Q&A call on a Thursday. So here the new whiteboard.
Yeah, of course it's the same tone range, but I don't know.
Let's fill that motherfucker up. So now we are gonna do some crazy morning routines here, right?
4 or 5 in the morning.
Jumping into this thing, you gotta be on a different mindset, right? Jumping into this thing. Sun hasn't even gone up. These pussies, it's 9 a.m. in the morning and they cannot even get out of their warm bed.
Man, this is like the real steroids.
Bro.
Legit steroids.
You gotta have a different fucking mentality. The David Goggins shit.
How can they win from us when we have the ice stuff?
No, they cannot. They cannot. We are on steroids, man. No. Different.
Thursday evening trim, guys.
Fresh root? You fresh?
Always. Yes, people, time for that weekly trim again.
Yeah, Ruben is already getting chopped up. Obviously, we have some Fredo on. Hardest session of the year. Fredo Daily Duppy, right, Ruben? Man, this guy spits lines that we fucking live right now, man. Crazy shit.
Guys, if you don't listen to rap music, man, I cannot relate. I cannot relate. These lines, they just hit fucking different. Making more meals. Sky protects you. What does your dog do? Your dog only shits on the wall, man. My dog protects. Yeah. Yeah, while you're getting a little your hair chopped up. Guys, fucking coconut water. Man, I love coconut water. It's clean, tastes good as fuck. 0 calories or something. Can just sip on this shit, man. While you listen to some Fredo. Waiting before Ruben's hair is fucking cut.
every day that I'm here in my fucking house, I know why I'm grinding. I love my penthouse. Just look at my fucking house. It's clean as fuck. I grind for things like this. Gangster as shit. The game's full of fucking clowns, man. Talk about them e-com gurus or something. That do no numbers, but act as if they do something. Bro, what they make in a month, that are my transaction fees, man. What they make in a month, that's what I spend for fun. What they make in a month is simply to maintain my lifestyle, man. Fucking pussies.
Where are we going to?
Yeah, so we're going to the PC Hoofdstraat, of course.
Little shopping spree.
Bro, the money doesn't spend itself, you know? I learned one lesson, and that is spend your money. Hey Sky, yeah. Don't break your neck.
Everything alright?
Everything okay? Big dog. Let's go. So, little shopping spree. I already connected my persons from Louis V and Dior. It's always good to have persons or managers there, you know? Especially if you want to skip the line. Yeah, they already said you can come. Well, so now it's already 12, so a bit late, but doesn't matter. But guys, you need to spend your money sometimes, right? One of the lessons I learned is to invest and spend money. I don't necessarily mean by that spending your money on bullshit and designer, but saving money is a myth. Saving will not make you rich. Abundance mindset, everything more, make more, spend more, do more. That's the thing. I've always done that. That's why we are leveling up in every way, lifestyle, the amount of numbers we are doing. If we had a fear-based mentality and we were thinking small, you think we would do like 2 million this month already? Let me show you guys what we're doing this month. Fucking nuts, man. While most of you people are sleeping, and while my Instagram is getting shut down left, right, and center, we keep printing. Here, this month, don't know if you can see it.
Already on 1 million.
Already 1 million. This is only the Eurostore, man. Bruv, it's September 14th. What are you doing this month? Come on, man. Level up yourself, your lifestyle, connect with people. Networking is important, especially once you start doing good. Don't be this guy like, oh, I don't need nobody. Connect with others and yeah, live the life you want to live. That's it, right?
These kids ask you to ref.
Fuck them. I don't ref for little kids. Especially not the fucked up kids.
It's here in Old South.
In Old South, all daddy's money, you know. We used to live in this neighborhood, but all these kids here, they're messed up, man.
They only smoke weed and pop pills, man. 10, 12 years old.
They do absolutely nothing here, bro. They're also not hungry for success or whatever, because their dad already has a Bentley.
When we were young, we need to work to get some bread and buy some energy drinks and milk at chocolate bars at the supermarket.
Have the newest shoes, everything. Fucking hell, man. How much are we gonna spend, Ruben?
10k.
10k?
Yeah.
That's pocket change, right?
Yeah, 100%.
That's what we make before lunch.
Let's check on what how much we earn now this morning.
These gurus make in a month to flex is what we spend to maintain our lifestyle.
There. We're already on 20k, so performance
is... So we're gonna blow it off!
Performance is not that good today, but it's still fine. It's 12 p.m. Today will be around 60k, I think. Oh, no, it will be 80k, because tonight we will send out an email as well. Hey, they also have the Lambo here. The Lambo.
The Lambo.
Yeah, the Lambo.
Lambo truck. That's a Lambo truck, nigga! They're hiring at fucking McDonald's, nigga. They're hiring at McDonald's. You choose. You're gonna work for the McDonald's or you're gonna pull up in Lambos in your 20s.
Maybe you get some free chicken nuggets.
Yeah, bro.
They give you 7 instead of 6.
Hey, did you see the move they're trying to play? They put like a little light-skinned kid with a little fade there. That's what they do, right? They're like, yes, it's okay.
That's the secret.
It's okay to be there working at the McDonald's with your little fade and your little trim. No, motherfucker. It's not
so normal. They are running away from the Euros.
Yeah, of course. They should be. And this is also the other option. Guys, we show you the options, right? Here. Trash wagon. You choose trash wagon, McDonald's,
or G-Wagon.
Or G-Wagon. Guys, you can drive a truck like this to pick up trash, or you can drive a fucking Lambo truck. I swear, the worst thing are people who say things like that are normal. It's not normal. What the fuck? You grow up in Europe and you
think it's normal to work for the McDonald's. It's normal to do trash or a minimum wage job. Nah, pussy. That's not fucking normal. That's failing. That's failing deeply in life, man. What the fuck? You have all the opportunities here. Man, if people are like, oh, you can accept that shit. Yeah, fuck them, man. Fuck them. Fuck them all.
Yeah, man, of course. In the beginning, when you're 30, 40, 50 years old, you need to do fucking anything to get money. And you can even work for a fucking McDonald's or wash dishes or clean houses, what we've also did. But when you're getting older, you will not be satisfied with that. You need to do everything as a man to earn that money.
Most of you people, you have no fucking idea how big this opportunity is right now. It's 2023, everyone is shopping online. Why the hell are you not selling online? You really clearly don't understand, right? Because people are like, Samuel, how are you able to grind so hard, this and that? Bro, you don't understand. We started at absolutely nothing and now we have everything. Why would we get comfortable now? These pussies, their mentality is so shit. And that's the good and the bad thing at the same time, because there's no competition, man. None. All these pussies soft, lazy on the couch all day. You can literally grab everything you fucking want, man. Here almost at PC Hofstraat. So yeah, let's see if they have something in store for us.
Always, they put something in the back for us. Some exclusive shit.
Some exclusive drip. Sky, maybe they have something for you too? Sky always gets the best service.
Hi, sir. How are you? Hello. Met mij?
Oh ja.
Ja.
Welkom.
Alles goed?
Ja, met jullie
super.
Ook.
Yes. Super. That's why you have small dogs. Just pick them up. Let's see if they have some good pieces to it.
What's the jacket saying, Ruben?
Of course.
For the winter?
This one.
So. In Dutch we say kankervel.
Kankervel.
But it's empty in VC. Dior here as well. I like it, but I'm thinking like, what's the reason? Either people don't have money, they spend their money. But the fact is, the most people that shop at Dior, Louis, it are people that are not really rich. It are all the workers, the 9-to-5, that make 2K a month and spend 1K on some Dior. Man. You're gonna fuck some people up, man.
What's the jacket saying?
It's saying problem. What do you people say, cop or drop? Let me check this one. You know, I want some unique pieces. Everyone has the basics.
So what's this piece saying then?
Cocaine white.
Cocaine white, Pablo Escobar, man. Some ice on the wrist, you know how we do.
No, but it looks good.
It looks good.
It's clean.
It's clean, but will you wear this often, or does it only look good right now because I have white pants?
Yes.
This shirt and the blue one. Also, this pants unique, but
so. What are the shoes saying?
I like them.
I have these ones here. What do you think of these one, people? If they fit good, I'm gonna get these because I wear white a lot and blue a lot. So you gotta combine your colors properly. Guys, I'm not even in my best shape. A little too much food. But still, what the fuck are we doing? Doing good, nigga. More oversized fit, size large. Think it's good, no? Yeah. Gotta cop that one. I like to wear oversized, you know, when I'm working. But I like fitted too. My Under Armour, you know, guys know. Guys, I'm fucking ready for a white party, man. Bring me to Sensation White. Jeez. No, I like this shirt. It has the small Dior logo here. The holes also on the back. I don't know if you can see it. Wait. But it says Dior on the back. Definitely gonna cop this one. Crispy, nigga. Crispy. Jeez, guys. Rate this full top to bottom fit. Pablo Escobar, cocaine white, man. Call me for the fucking white party. No, but this fit is very good. Only the pants are a bit too tight. I can feel it, but I'm gonna check if they have a size up. I think it's a cup. The only thing with this is, when are you gonna wear it, you know? That's sometimes the thing.
because you are here in Dior or Louis, whatever. Often you see a fit and it just hits, but then you buy it and then you're like, when the fuck am I gonna wear this shit? But I think this will come to the occasion, so yeah, man.
Pull up with this jacket in the SVR, white interior, ebony white. Let's see how the shoes match together. The fuck is this fit saying, man? I know what this says. This says a million a month already. Let's start for food.
Zo'n oudje.
Easy things. We said 10 and it was 9, so very close. This is a little fast 10k, right, River?
Yeah, 10k in
10 minutes.
But that's the first shop.
I think that's,
that's the first shop.
That's a new record, right?
Yeah.
I think Usain Bolt doesn't do it that fast.
Yes, people.
That's when you know when you're in the Netherlands. Louis Vuitton had a little heated argument upstairs there because I had these bags. I said, okay, put them to the side somewhere behind, because that's what they do everywhere at designer stores, especially in Dubai, places like that. Put your bag to the side for you, things like that. They were with like five people staring at me as if I asked if I could shit on the ground. Crazy, man. But that's that Netherlands mentality sometimes. But yeah, we're shopping here right now. What do you think of this little vest? Really like it. Then we have here the tracksuit, fully top bottom. What do you guys say? I like it. It's good for when you go to the office or you catching flights. Nice and comfortable, clean. Little shirt. Like the design. Good sizing. A little bit oversized. Here we have the bottoms as well. Full set. Ruben, you found something nice already?
Yeah, one shirt.
Good fit?
Yeah, fitting is good.
And then what happened? So one of the workers here came up to me apologizing for what happened because they found out someone was a VIP customer. Guys, I have a verified Louis Vuitton account. You don't get that shit by chance. No. You have to do some crazy spendings for that one. Plus, VIP client being verified with Louis Vuitton, not only spending, you have to do something special. And I have done some crazy things. I was spending so much on Louis Vuitton one day online. I spent like 30, 40K in 1 week. Their fraud system went up, so it was all kind of craziness. They canceled my orders and things like that because they thought it was fraud. So I then got in touch with their VIP online client support and have a contact person there. They were like, nah, we need to verify you very fast so this shit doesn't happen again. So now we are here. Hey Ruben, they found out we are verified clients.
Yeah, and then they come apologize.
Yeah, bitches, scumbags.
Why do we need to tell everybody a lesson?
Yeah, that's why you have to say your shit.
Don't let people walk over
you. No, you never let people walk over you. Guys, when I say we had a little heated argument, you guys know me, Ruben. We don't take shit, so we didn't. And what are we now still doing? I wanted to walk away. Ruben said, no, we stay. We buy some shit. So yeah, that's what we are doing.
Cup or drop,
guys. What the fuck is this saying? I said, Ruben, did you start smoking weed again? Crazy colors. I think the fit itself is good, but the design...
Yeah, the design is not it.
No.
With the boundaries.
But the thing is, we can still pull it off.
Yeah.
But Joris cannot, and Jan can also not. If he walks around in that thing, he looks like a fucking weirdo. What is the physique saying?
How's your physique, man?
What do you eat?
Chicken and rice. And ground beef.
Yes.
16K further. That's how we do it, right?
We don't need your gym tonight. No, they will steal it out of the car. You cannot leave for 16K designer. Oh, for 16. I walk with the stanky link.
Injured. I'm injured.
Yeah.
Man down. You don't have to go to the gym anymore.
I already did some boxing in the morning.
What did you do with these shoes, man? Come on.
Hey,
don't bite on the shoes,
man. Guys, you remember in that vlog I walked towards some shoes here? I think I found them.
No, these here. Down below.
Oh no.
Are the Amazon FBA shoes.
For the guys that sell on Amazon, they walk on shit like this. Man, they don't have a clue what the fuck they are doing. You gotta have your own store.
I think I need these for the marathon. I walk 2 times as fast.
I think you need these. If someone is trying to rob you, you just smack them one time on the back of the head with this, and then they never wake up. They never wake up again. Hey guys, something interesting happened. They were instantly, should we put your bags away? What the fuck just happened in the Louis? I was not playing, man. They were trying to fuck with us. Guess what? We still spent though. What was it? 6,000? Little 6,000. Pocket change. Oh, this is for the
people that
do protests.
That cut themselves.
cut. Donker en duisternis. Duisternis. Guys, Tate says depression is not real, right? What do you think, Ruben? What is your opinion on that? It's fugazi, right? We don't need to be happy. We need to make money. But they say, yeah, but money doesn't make you happy. Bro, if I can buy what the fuck I want, that's good.
Sammy, what do you think? Cop or drop?
Cop.
Hij is op zich niet verkeerd.
So, when at first the Shopify...
when the first Shopify is still coming in. What the fuck do you have to say, man? I make money. I make money, maybe.
You don't have to go to the gym anymore. But, ciao. We just dropped a little 20. Drop a little 20 on the motherfuckers, you know.
Ben je voetballer, broer?
Nee, man. Ondernemer.
Netjes, man. Goed gedaan, nee.
Thanks, man. Thanks.
Netjes, respect, man. Ga zo door, man.
Thanks, bro.
Thanks.
Sowieso. Goeie, blijf groeien.
Ja, blijf je stappen maken.
Zo is het leuk. Heb je goede tips? Crypto tips of andere tips?
Stoppen met smoken. ja. Dat is de beste tip die ik je kan geven.
Ik spook er vroeger ook.
Ja.
Dat is 8k per jaar wat ik rook.
Ja, daarom.
Dat is wat je rookt. Maar
dat is wat ik rook alleen al. Dat is nog lifestyle als niet wij in begrijpen.
Ja, maar daarom mentaal. Het is mentaal. Wij smokten vroeger ook. Maar sinds we daarmee gestopt zijn, is alles level up gegaan.
Serieus,
man? Ja, bro, sowieso. Ja, weet je
wat? Ziet er wel sporty uit, hè?
Ja, daarom. Ja.
Shiny Beach Boys.
Vroeger toen we jong waren, smokten we iedere dag. Ja, man.
Maar wat is het beste om je hoofd in te steken,
zaken? E-commerce, 100%.
Dus online producten kopen. Iedereen koopt tegenwoordig online. Dus als jij, en je kunt gewoon producten aanbieden. Die bijvoorbeeld vanuit China komen.
Ja, nee.
En dan kun je gewoon een marge.
Ja, man. Iedereen shopt online tegenwoordig. Take care. Rustig aan, boys. Ciao, ciao.
Dankjewel.
Geen probleem.
Geen probleem, man.
Je kan er wel even snel in zitten.
Ja, man.
Ja, man. Dat is wel wat, of niet?
Jazeker. Ik heb in allerlei auto's gekregen, maar dit gaat je verbaasd. Ik heb nog nooit in een Uber
gezien. Nee? Nee. De interieur is top, hè, met het oranje.
De SUV is ook.
Ja, man.
Sowieso. Dank u wel.
Top, is goed. Rustig aan, jongen.
Let's see if it fit, guys. That's a little 20k. Light work. Bang. Light work. Let's move.
Dude, what the fuck is this video?
The prices for groceries went up.
The
man.
Grocery prices went up.
Man, the groceries are fucking expensive. Now if you go to the
Ruben is telling me, yeah, it's crazy the prices here in the Netherlands. Bruv, we dropped 20,000 bands 1 hour ago.
Yeah, but the groceries are still expensive.
What the fuck? Bro, click back to the thumbnail. Click back, return.
Yeah.
Return. I pay 20 to 30 euros more a week. Ruben, what the fuck?
We just spent
20,000 in 1 hour. Yeah. What the fuck, man?
Sorry.
Winning.
Yeah, guys. So I was working in the living room. Walk to the kitchen.
Next time in Onuha Uncensored.
1 hour away. Caps launch.
1,100 people on the floor.
Q4. It was Sunday morning. Are you ready? You still seem a little bit asleep, but after. Come on, bro.